Welcome to Die Trying.
Build something new.
I'm Patrick Norton.
I'm Michael Hand.
Michael has what we would call an addiction, were it, well, heroin or alcohol or methamphetamine, but since it's unusual electronic components from places you've never heard of on eBay or Alibaba Express, it's a hobby. Actually, it's a career.
Yeah, I don't know what you would expect me to do. We would do a DIY show.
You have a lot. Well, it's just, it's cool. This is actually something you found recently. What is it?
This is a Qi charger, Qi charger. It's kind of like a standard, or as close to a standard of wireless charging as you get at this point.
It's the wireless charging system that works with the Nexus phones and most of the Android phones.
Yeah, so instead of having the whole, like, covered in plastic and the little spot that you put it, this is just like the base components. Our plan is to put this inside of this.
Yes, we are going to have a charging stick. Well, actually, you had you were inspired by a website you saw.
Yes, so I saw on the XDA forums, someone built a really nice charger where they took one of these and put it and made a really nice looking stand. There's a little half mock-up that we made.
Yeah, we spent a bunch of time mocking this up. Essentially, we were gonna drill down as thin as we can with the Forstner bit. We're going to mount the wireless coil. In theory, we're going to put some magnets in that'll help hold the phone to the charger and keep it from falling over. But mostly, it's kind of funny. Charging, not charging. Charging, not charging.
Yeah, the target zone is kind of small, at least with this thing. So we have to have things placed just in the right way.
And hopefully we figured all that out, or else we will weep. We won't die, we'll just weep trying.
Or we'll just fake it and then...
We don't fake it on this show. So after working our mock-up, Michael went out and selected the finest piece of red oak he could find at the local Lowe's Lumber.
And this was the best one.
You looked at all of them. I know because we got that look that I often get from the lumber store people when I go through every single piece of wood in the stack. So should we see if we can make this pretty?
And let's try it.
Drill holes in it? Well, we don't have to drill the holes in it, but it's not going to be much of a have your moment. We could go get another stick.
So first we need to make an angled cut in the wood because we're going to have it like a stand sort of thing.
Right, so there's a base and the front of the base is going to come down to the, basically this is going to go like this. There's going to be a piece supporting it in the back. You really like the 35 degree angle, so we're going to cut the bottom of this piece at a 35 degree angle and the front of the base at a 35 degree angle. And if that doesn't make sense, it will in just a second.
And we're taping our wood because our blade isn't the best.
You can use a new
right
blade
now.
Or a blade sharpen. And we're cross cutting on hardwood. So I'm going to turn this a little bit because if I slip,
back.
I'll be the one screaming and going to the hospital.
Looks perfect.
So this will be part of our base and this is going to slide down right there. And we're gonna glue and pocket screw the base onto the vertical there.
That's the idea.
Ta-da! Now comes the fun part.
Drilling.
Yay! These are Forstner bits. What's cool about these is it's essentially a chisel face, and then these teeth out here saw the outside of your circle. So the point sets the center of your circle, and as it spins, it shaves off little curly cues of wood, in fact. From our early efforts, little curly cues of wood.
Cool.
Curly cue.
So it'll make life easy.
Yeah, the one thing I wish is if we had a second 2-inch Forstner bit for this, we could shave this off and we could get even lower to the surface of the wood on the other side.
Because we want to get as low as possible with this so that the wireless coils and the phone are as close as possible.
Bingo. Plus our magnets, but we'll talk about magnets in a minute.
All right.
So what I did is I set our drill press down basically within a millimeter of the plate using the depth guide. So this will either work really well or I'll be sad. But we have more wood. Are we gonna be doing magnets on this one?
That's the plan. So the whole back is pretty magnetic in that area. Mm-hmm. So in theory, if we put four magnets, it should hold it up a little bit better and align things in the right place.
So the magnets went in, then the coil went back in. The coil that worked before we put the magnets in...
No longer worked.
It was a
fail. Just put it that way.
Yeah. So what we didn't realize until we looked back at the instructions was that they hadn't used drill bits to drill out the holes for the magnets. They'd used an end mill, a big flat bottom half inch end mill to hog out the holes for the magnets as close to the surface of the wood on the other side they could get. So a couple minutes later with the chop saw, the first attempt at a oak charging stand is now a lovely refrigerator magnet.
Q-build 2.
Which of course has me back in the drill press with the Forstner bit, and since we didn't have an end mill, I used a half inch router bit we had queued up into the drill press. By the way, if you're thinking to yourself, gosh, couldn't these guys have sat down and designed something beforehand using some sophisticated modern CAD software? I'd like to point you to our sponsor, lynda.com/DIY, who in fact, amongst the incredible array of video lessons, online tutorials available, has an actual collection of AutoCAD tutorials. And I will actually be spending quality time with that because it's time for me to start designing before I start drilling.
So they're just winging it as we go along.
We do that sometimes. lynda.com/DIY if you don't want to just wing it. Just to give our coil a little bit more advantage, I routed out the center of that 2-inch hole where the coil was going down into. Probably not the safest thing I've done in this workshop, which is kind of frightening to think about. 6 magnets and a pile of crazy glue later, we popped the coil into place, and lo and behold,
we've got a nice little charging stand. Blue means it's charging, so it's charging my phone right now.
Now, you may notice a certain lack of sophistication and savoir faire in our completion of the design. This is the power supply that feeds our induction plate.
This project. You would think that would be easy to put a little charger coil in a piece of wood, but it's not.
Partially because, my woodworking skills are apparently even worse than I remember, and Michael's are...
I never had a wood chop.
Well, it's and it more's the pity, and if your child has the opportunity to take wood chop, let them. Yeah. It was funny. It's also part of the problem, right? Induction charging is finicky.
And not the most efficient.
What did you say? It was like 10 minutes to raise it 2%?
It's something like that. It takes a while. I don't know if I would use this on a regular basis.
Why? Because you're afraid the heat from the induction charging will light the oak on fire?
Maybe.
It was funny. The original idea for this was to take, this is basswood. It's kind of a cousin to balsa wood. It's commonly available in hobby shops, your better equipped hardware store. My original idea was to take a piece of wood, route it out, and mount the induction and the induction coil and the magnets to the basswood, and they just have a nice charging sort of plate.
Do that. Get thin wood.
Yeah.
Don't bring routers and drills into this.
Well, Or do it.
It's a challenge.
And post a link down below. Do us a favor, subscribe. Most of our builds have us much happier at the end. You can find out examples of us looking enthusiastic at youtube.com/dietryon or dietryon.com. Please subscribe.
Thank you. Thank you for doing that.
Here.
I'd say just plug in for right now.
I'm Patrick Norton.
I'm Michael Hand.
We'll see you next week on Dietryon.
One thing go right today. Come on.
Where's my charging?
Well, we made a nice stand. Maybe someday it'll be wireless.